प्रीति विल डिस्कस अबाउट दी नाउ
ओके
प्रीति विल गिव सम होम्योपैथिक अप्लायंसेस एंड इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स प्रीति स्टार्ट
Good morning, everyone. Good morning, sir. Last class, when I was giving the seminar, I spoke about spatula. And now we will go with bottles. Bottles or glass toppered bottles. And these should be used for substances which corrode cork. That is, substances such as acids, chlorine, bromine, iodine, which have iodine preparations. Chloroform or creosote in their 1x or 2x potencies. Next, stoppers made of glass should be used, which prevent the introduction of glass particles into the drugs from friction of glass stoppers in opening as well as shutting them. Here, glass refers to potash glass or Bohemian glass, which consists of 71% of silicon dioxide. And 11% of calcium oxide, 18% of potassium. In other cases, Jena glass and Pyrex glass are also preferable. And colored glass bottles are used where contents may be affected by light or sunlight. Uses of the glass toppered bottles. All homeopathic mother tinctures and mother solutions will be stored in glass toppered bottles only. Except for a few. In certain cases of acids such as fluoric acid, glass stoppered bottles will prove inefficient because the acids will eat away the whole glass, no matter how hard the or how hard or strong the glass may be. So in such cases, gutta percha bottles or other kind of containers serve useful for that purpose. The black colored bottle you see here is the gutta percha bottle, while the normal bottles we see are used for the storage of other drug substances. Cleansing of the bottles. The bottles are kept in cold or rain water for almost 6 to 7 hours. And by using hard brush, they are washed several times by shaking and brushing consecutively, that is, first we shake it and then brush and then again shake and brush. This helps in removing of stains, any kind of precipitates or dirt. Then they are washed with moderately warm water and rubbed with the soft brush. And after using warm water, they are purified using the purified water. And after washing it with purified water, some amount of strong alcohol is poured inside the bottles to wash them properly. Then the bottles are exposed to sun for the drying purpose. The schematic representation will be the following steps: brushing with hard brush, shaking and brushing consecutively, washing with moderately warm water and usage of the soft brush, then washing with purified water, pouring of alcohol and rinsing properly, and finally, the bottles being exposed to sun for drying purpose. Next, coming to the chopping board. The chopping board are made up of sound and strong free wood, which are free from any kind of holes and knots. It may be either circular or oval shaped. Centrally, it is concave with a prominent margin. Marble or even glazing porcelain slabs may serve better as they are easy to be cleaned. In some cases, even a rectangular chopping board can be used. Uses of the chopping board are, they are used as the base for cutting fresh medicinal plants, herbs, roots, basks and flowers into small pieces. The cleansing is done cleansed thoroughly after using and then dried well before the next use. Here you can see images of a rectangular chopping board and a circular or oval shaped chopping board. Next comes the chopping knife. The chopping knife should be made of very good steel. They should always be well polished and free from rust, as rust decomposes many vegetable juices at once. One side of the blade is sharp for the chopping of the soft substances. An iron-made chopping knife should never be used, as it may form rust. Uses of the chopping knife are, soft vegetable substances are chopped by using the chopping knife, and it is placed over the concave surface of the chopping board. It should always be wiped off after washing and kept dry to avoid rusting.
Sir,
next, coming to...
Yes.
Sir, kontamandi disconnect ayyaru waiting room lo unnaru, allow cheyali sir.
Em cheddam? Undani.
Okay sir.
Preeti, you continue beta.
Yes sir. Spoons, these spoons are usually different than our regular spoons. They are a little bit wider and concave in nature, and even their handle is a bit different. If you notice the picture, you will see that they are different from our regular spoons that we use. They are made up of ivory, horn, bone, porcelain or stainless steel. The uses of the spoon are, it is used to transfer liquid or semi-liquid substances from one container to another, and also in handling sugar of milk and some other purposes. Next, coming to the sieve. Perforated bottom for separating fine powders from coarser substances. The sieves that are used today are made up of silk, hair or stainless steel wire. But homeopathic pharmacopoeia will advise the use of hair or silk sieves only. Sieves and their types and uses. The first type of sieve we will see is silk sieve. It is useful in making triturations. And for very fine powder, we will use 80 meshes sieve in 1 square inch. And all the potencies here will pass through the 80 number sieve. For fine powder, 60 meshes sieve in a square inch. Here, all the particles will...
Preeti.
Yes, sir.
Just now, before this, one minute back, you made a sentence, all the potencies. I'm unable to understand what you are explaining about that, all the potencies.
Sir, here when we make the trituration, sir, and we are using the sieves for very fine powder, all the types of drug substances will pass through this, sir.
It's not like that, ma. See, you know, everyone, you know that the various sizes of the globules. Globules are prepared. What is the name of the globule preparation? What is that name? You are preparing the globules? Stainless steel?
Stainless steel, silk or hair, sir?
No. Globules we are preparing. What? We are preparing the globules. What is that appliance, the name? Anyone can. Global preparation. Anyone, these many people are there. You are unable, you are not recollecting the past what we learned. Globules preparation. Globules preparation. What is the machine we are using? What is the name?
Stainless steel round rotator.
Exact word. I need an exact word. What we'll do? We'll get equal size of the globules. Preeti, once the
yes,
globules,
sir.
we'll get equal size of the globules. In the global,
no.
So there are various. So you know the preparation of the, you know the process of preparation of the globules. Okay, finally all the globules are, finally all the globules are taken, and the simultaneously trituration powders are taken. Here sieves are nothing but, so we are separating the large, medium, small and very small powders, globules, all the material. The main purpose of sieve is not, so you are shown the image. In that image, different type of the, so what it is there, mesh, what is that, 80 sieve in a square inch, the square inch that box is there, that 80, 60, 40, like that only. So more than the size of the powder, the size of the globule, which is more than 80. So we can segregate, we can separate. The remaining things will be collected. Remaining things will be passed through the next level, 60, next level 40, then next level 20. So please everyone try to understand that. In a household, what we'll do, commonly we are using rava, Bombay rava, Godhuma rava, atta. What our, in our mother and our family members who are there in the kitchen, what they will do, how they will separate the fine powder, how they will separate the medium size of all these, they are using all the meshes. All the meshes. So before going the process of getting the starch to the girni, chakki, what they will do, they make the mesh. With the help of the sieve, they will remove the stones, they will remove the pellets, they remove the mud. Finally, all the jova, all the whatever the grains, they will collect it. Right? So these are various, it is. In simple understanding, it is nothing but just separating the equal size. So with this, what happened? We are getting equal size of the 60 size of the globule, 50 size of the globule, 40 size of the globule, yes, 35 size of the globule, 20 size of the globule, 10 size of the globule. You know that. What are the various sizes of the globules? Got my point?
Yes, sir.
Right, go ahead.
So for very fine powder, we use 80 meshes sieve in a square inch. And for fine powder, we use 60 meshes sieve in a square inch. So here, the 60 size globules will pass through the sieve. For hair or stainless steel wire sieve, which is also used in making triturations, we will use for moderately coarse powder, 40 meshes sieve in a square inch. Here, the particle size of 40 will pass through the sieve and others will not pass through. And for coarse powder, we use 20 meshes sieve in a square inch. But situations where acid substances are to be shifted by using a sieve, a horsehair sieve will be used. Thank you, sir.
You mentioned this point?
No, sir. In the PPT, it was not sufficient, sir.
You like the situation, sir. A very important point is a PG question point. You have to take another slide and you have to give the information. You have collected vast information, nice presentation, good explanation. All the points you are told, you have taken all, even though. See, why I have given this topic for you people, I think you understood that. See, every day we are in the laboratory, every time in front of us, all these appliances are there. If we are not the qualitative points, if we are not learning, examiner will ask, what are the uses of the spoon? If you say simply taking for the honey, taking for the something, it is a fun making thing, but it is, it can't be tolerated by the examiner. So scientific words should be there. So what the chopping board, if you say that chopping board is for the cutting the vegetables, It's not like that. So scientific point we are learning in the homeopathic pharmacy laboratory. What is the need of keeping of the spoon? What is the need of keeping of the knife? What is the need of the keeping of the sieve? What is the need of the keeping of the chopping board? Yes, all these points. So that's what we are making. We are taking for the discussion. This discussion is helps us speak about pharmacy, homeopathic pharmacy, the classroom, in laboratory pharmacy. What the uses of them? What the uses of them? Sometimes we need to take something. So the instruments, and very good. You are given bottles, Gutta-Percha bottle, and just now you are told that what is that? Zenna glass. You are told about the Zenna glass.
Yes, sir.
Zenna glass and Bohemian. Bohemian glass is 100 times important for examination point of view. You see the previous question papers. 100 times important. Every time Bohemian glass is the 2 marks question. If we are not given concentration about that point, you will learn. Or I read sometimes what is that? Bohemian glass, Zenna glass, Bohemian glass. So then you are unable to give some answer. So bottles and bottles, glass bottles, and they should not be kept. Whatever may be the material for the cap, stopper, glass stopper. So these are made up of Zenna. These are made up of Bohemian. These are made up of silica. Yes, nice presentation, Ramya.
Thank you, sir.
Yes. Avinash will continue the topic.
Good morning, everyone. Today I'm going to discuss about homeopathic pharmaceutical instrument and appliances. What are the topics to be discussed? First, lactometer, porcelain basin, crucible, corks, and cleansing of corks. Lactometer. It is a glass tube with a bulge in the middle part. The bottom is a bulb with a few spots. The top portion is a tube closed at the end and graduated. The marking gives the readings of specific gravity. The instrument registers specific gravity from 1015 to 1040. As the first two digits are omitted, only which is 15 is written in the place of 1015. Lactometer is graduated for a definite temperature, especially 60 degree Fahrenheit. When lactometer is used for other temperatures, add 0.1 to the readings of every degree above 60 degree Fahrenheit, or subtract 0.1 from the reading of every degree below 60 degree Fahrenheit. Uses. It is used for testing milk. It was first invented by Mr. Dickers of Liverpool. What is the principle behind the lactometer? It works on the principle of specific gravity of milk. It is known as Archimedes' principle. If this specific gravity of a sample of milk is within the approved ranges, the milk is pure. If it is not, then there is some adulterations. This is the lactometer. At the middle, it is bulged, and at the top, it is graduated markings are present, and at the bottom, a few spots are present.
Bulb is filled
How
with.
Do you check?
Bulb is filled with.
Lead shots, sir.
Lead shots, right. Go ahead.
How do you check lactometer reading? Dip the meter bulb in it, the bulb going first. You will notice that the meter bulb floats. The reading on the meter indicates how pure or impure the milk is. The deeper the bulb sinks, the more dilute or impure the milk. Principle. As we know that Archimedes principle, that a body floating in water is buoyed up by a force equal to the weight of water displaced at 60 degree Fahrenheit or 15.5 degree centigrade. what are the materials which is present in the milk? The following specific gravities: water, 1 gram by ml, fat, 0.93 gram by ml, solid, it is not the fat, 1.610 gram by ml. This is a lactometer. Then the porcelain basin. Evaporating dish is a piece of laboratory glass. Glassware used for the evaporation of solutions and supernatant liquids and sometimes to their melting point. Evaporating dishes are used to evaporate excess solvents, most commonly water, to produce a concentrated solution or a solid precipitate of the dissolved substances. Most are made up of porcelain or borosilicate glass. Shallow glass evaporating dishes are commonly termed as watch glasses. The capacity of evaporators is usually small, in the range 3 to 10 ml. The larger dishes up to 100 ml are different in shapes and more hemispherical. The evaporators is used most often in quantitative analysis. This is a generic evaporator dish. The shapes of evaporating dishes encourage evaporation in two ways. First of all, the shell is relatively flat. A relatively large liquid surface promotes evaporation. If heated in a flask or beaker, a part of evaporation liquid condenses on the vessel walls and flows back into the solution. This does not happen in the dish. Why is an evaporating dish is better than a beaker? The main reason is speed up the evaporation. Here the unique shapes of evaporation dishes aids in evaporation in two ways. First of all, the liquid inside has a large surface area, speeding up evaporation process. The open top allows vapors to dissipate when compared to a more contained piece of glass like a beaker or a flask, which leads to speed up of evaporation. This is a porcelain basin. Then crucible. A ceramic or metal container, the crucible tipped and the mold filled with liquid metal. It is made up of porcelain. It is used for drying the hard substances in small amounts at a high temperatures. For drying at very high temperature, the crucible is made up of silica. This is a melting gold in a graphite crucible. And these are the crucibles which are used by Thomas Edison in his experiments. Crucibles are available in several sizes and typically come with a corresponding size lid. When heated over a flame, the crucible is often held inside a pipe clay triangle, which itself is held on a top of a tripod. Crucibles and their covers are made up of high temperature resistant materials, usually porcelain, alumina, or an inert materials. One of the earliest uses of platinum was to make crucible. Crucibles and their lids can come in high forms and low form shapes and in various sizes, but rather small 10 to 15 ml size porcelain crucibles are commonly used for gravimetric chemical analysis. This is a modern crucible, which is used in the production of silicon ignots via Suzukrasky process. In the silver ignots, the silver metal get be melts into small sizes. The ceramics such as alumina, zirconia, and especially magnesia will tolerate the high temperatures. More recently, metals such as nickel and zirconium have been used. The lids are typically loose-fitting to allow gases to escape during heating of a sample inside. What is G4 crucible? A Gooch crucible, named after Frank Austin Gooch, is a filtration device for laboratory use and was also called as Gooch filter. It is convenient for collecting a precipitate directly within the vessel in which it is to be dried, possibly ashed, and finally weighed in the gravimetric analysis. This is a Gooch crucible or G4 crucible. What is sintered glass crucible? is thus mainly to filter solutions and mixtures when the residue is desired and the minimal residue is sought in the filtrator. It is also used in the place of filter papers. It can be less porous and thus making it cheaper. This is sintered glass crucible, and it is a funnel, sintered glass funnels. How do you clean sintered glass crucible? Carefully add 15 ml 30% of hydrogen peroxide or 1/3 the volume of sulfuric acid used to the Bushnell funnel and stand back. Let the reaction proceed for about a minute and then apply a quick vacuum, just enough to pull the solution through the sinter into the flask, and the sinter is dry. Why is sintered glass crucible is much more preferred than Gooch crucible? Sintered glass crucible, it is a glass crucible with a porous glass disc sealed into the bottom. It is very convenient to use because no preparation is needed as with the Gooch crucible. This is a crucible, normal crucible. And now going box. It should be of best velvet quality, smooth, well polished, and without any holes or discoloration. As soon as they shrink or become soft, they should be replaced by new ones. Never use any used box that has ever been in contact with any medicine. For every fresh bottle, a fresh cork should always be used. Then coming to cleansing of corks. The corks are firstly rubbed under running tap water and then with purified water in a hair sieve. Then they are kept to dry and after drying again rinsed with the dilute alcohol. Afterwards, they are dried thoroughly at the modern temperatures under sunrays. Note, the cork should never be treated with hot water or steam as it gives the irregular shapes and dingy color. As soon as they shrink, they should be rejected. This is a schematic representation. First, rubbed under running tap water, then washed with purified water in a hair sieve. After they are exposed to dry, after again rinsed with dilute alcohol, and finally dried thoroughly at a modern temperature. These are the corks. Thank you.
Avinash.
Sir.
Yes, very informative, excellent work you did, and you have collected. Your presentation has been, the information is, you have given a post-graduation information about the pharmacy. Very good, excellent. Ramya, go ahead.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
You are inviting the next person.
Yes, we conclude the topic homeopathic appliances and instruments. General laboratory and laboratory methods.
We have only 4 minutes, 30 seconds. Invite, who is the person next?
Me only, sir.
You only?
Yes. Yes,
go ahead.
Hello.
Yes, we are getting your voice.
Good morning, sir. Good morning, everyone. Today we are dealing with the topic general laboratory and laboratory method. The topics I am going to discuss are homeopathic laboratory, laboratory methods, and in general laboratory methods, sedimentation and decantation. Homeopathic laboratory, what are the qualities and conditions should have a homeopathic laboratory are location and surroundings. First, laboratory should never be situated adjacent to any factory and close to open sewage or public lavatory. General environment should be non-polluting. Next, room. Cutting, pounding, triturating should be protected from the rays of the sun, but should be light, should be moderately comfortable, and there should be constant circulation of the fresh air. The ambient light should be avoided and should be air-conditioned if possible. And the walls of the room are washable. The laboratory should be provided with sufficient quantity of the water for washing and cleansing purposes, and also has burning gas and electricity. The laboratory should have sufficient space for different departments like manufacturing, bonded laboratory for manufacturing alcohol, analytic laboratories, finished products, and packing departments. Furniture. The laboratory should be furnished moderately, made of seasonal wood, kept clean and well cared. Newly polished furniture should be dried first and then washed. Drawers should be made so that the medicines can separate, can kept separate. Next, arrangements. The raw materials and finished products should be kept separately. The working room as well as the storeroom for raw materials and finished products should be separate. Each product should be well stocked and properly labeled. Strong odorous drugs always kept away from the other drugs. The workers, they must have cloakroom to change their clothes and shoes and be free from any contagious or obnoxious diseases. They should be provided with sterilized dresses before use via mask and headwear. They should wash their hands with hands and feet using disinfectant soaps. These all are the qualities we can see in our pharmacy lab. Next, laboratory methods. What is solution? It can be defined as the homogeneous mixture of two or more substances. One of them is called a solute, and the other is the solute. The substance to be dissolved, which is doing dissolving, is solvent. With this, solute plus solvent is equal to solution. In this, we can see how the solution is formed. The solute dissolves in a solvent to form solution.